Bonjour, ni hao, buongiorno, guten morgen, privet, bom dia, jen dobre, namaste, maharba, guten tag, draste, buona, giorno pot, hallo, brien, madita, sin ciao, lavas, stravo, yasu, strupat, pranam, sasrikal, and welcome to our second online virtual celebration assembly. Good morning, teachers.
Good morning.
How are you all?
Really good.
Well, what an incredible week we have all had. I have been blown away. My mind has been blown away by your incredible learning online via Seesaw. We've had some incredible writing, artwork, creative writing stories, phonics, spaghetti bolognese, PE. Lots of incredible things. It must have been an incredibly tough choice, teachers, for you to pick your stars of the week. Mm-hmm. And I can't wait to find out who you have selected and who has been shining brightly online or in school this week. Shall we start with Mrs. Homburg? Good morning, Mrs. Homburg. How are you?
I'm going to put my sunglasses on because it is so shiny and bright in Brighton class. You would not believe how many children are joining in with the online learning and how much work they're doing and how passionate they are and dependable. And some of us have had to be quite resilient as well. And that's really coming on. Well done, Brighton class. So my star of the week has really shone really, really brightly. She has sent me some amazing videos and the passion shining out of those videos has been amazing. And in fact, I think she knows how special she's been this week. She sent me a little message saying, when am I going to be star of the week? And so, not to disappoint, the star of the week in Brighton class is Lily!
You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down.
Sunglasses.
See. Right, shall we go to Mrs. Kendall?
Hi, Mr. Parker. Are you okay? I'm very well, thank you. So, it's been another incredible week in Milne class. I've been kept so busy looking at and responding to all of the wonderful learning that's been taking place. We've been building kites, making worry dolls, looking at number bonds to 10. The list is just endless. I've gone, however, the person who's shone even brighter is someone who has had to, I'm sure they won't mind me saying, dig quite deeply this week, but she's kept on going and she's just shown me how dependable she is, just like Daisy. And she showed me just how creative she is too. So on Wednesday, she made the most incredible cubes out of paper on her own and then explained to me in detail how she'd done it. And most of all, she just makes me laugh out loud all of the time. So for those reasons, the star of the week in Milne class is Lawrence.
Good morning, Mr. Harrison. How are you?
Morning, Parker. Very well. How are you?
I'm okay, thank you. My beard is going more whiter by the day, and my ears seem to be getting hairier. But other than that, I'm very well. Thank you.
Delightful. So, start of the week in Rowling class. Tricky to choose because we've had so many children putting in so much effort to the learning. But the person I've gone for this week isn't just for the massive amount of effort that she's been putting in. It's also because on our class blog, she's been leaving really positive messages for the friends in her class saying, oh, I love this piece of work you've done, and giving bits of feedback to people, which I think is really kind. She did a really, really lovely version of Hey Jude for Mr. Morland's singing club. Just a delightful cover of it, and it was really nice to hear. She's got a lovely tone of voice. So for leaving those positive comments on other people's work, giving feedback, and for having a cracking singing voice, my star of the week is Eva. That's the way I like it. That's the way I like it.
nice to hear lots of empathy being shown as well. Fantastic. Let's go to Miss Robson. Good morning, Miss Robson.
Good morning, Mr. Parkhouse.
Are you well?
I'm very well, thank you.
Mixing with celebrities, of course, this week. Michael Rosen retweeting your rap.
Yes, I was feeling very proud of myself.
Quite rightly so.
So, Star of the Week in Rosen Class was really hard to choose again this week. The children have been absolutely fantastic. They've posted me so many pictures and videos and voice recordings. And the Star of the Week this week is somebody who was a little bit quiet last week, who I think was maybe feeling a little bit reluctant about home learning, but has absolutely thrown herself into it this week and has been absolutely amazing. She has sent me her wrapper book challenge, which was fantastic. I think she might be a bit of a trendsetter now with her amazing costume that she had on. And she's just been sending me loads and loads of brilliant responses to all the activities that I've been setting. So Star of the Week in Rosen Class is Michelle!
Mr. Morland.
Good morning, Mr. Parkhouse.
How are you?
I'm great, thank you very much. Nice to see you again. My Star of the Week has absolutely amazed me once again all week with their passion for online learning and the amount of incredible home learning they've done. Some of the things which we've suggested, but many other things that they sent me pictures and videos and drawings of things they've been doing. And also they've taken the opportunity to try out some new things as well and push themselves from areas where they felt perhaps a little bit yellow and to be intrepid. And quite clearly, my Star of the Week, and in fact, and his whole family, are clearly determined to do a great job. And furthermore, sent me the most incredible video of a ninja hamster. So my Star of the Week this week, for his phenomenal attitude home learning, is Lucas Hale.
Lucas! Well done, Lucas. Let's go to Miss Folks. Good morning.
Good morning. So, Donaldson's Star of the Week this week is somebody who is working so hard and showing such passion for her home learning. She has created her own library bus. She has created kites. She's been singing. She's been dancing. She's been counting. She's been writing. She's been drawing. She's just blowing me away. So Donaldson Class's Star of the Week this week is Bella!
Well done, Bella. Let's go to Mrs. Smithson. Good morning.
Good morning.
How is Stocky McSock face today?
Oh, Stocky McSock face is very well, thank you. Very well. So, my Pergo class have amazed me this week with their attitude to their learning. My Star of the Week is someone who has shown real resilience and has been sending me fantastic videos, creating games and playing with their toys, but in an educational way. It's a young man who has spent most of the week in his pyjamas, but has been learning in his pyjamas. I had a fantastic video of a game he created with his family using lots of energy in the garden. And today he has made the most amazing autism awareness rainbow outside his house. So my Star of the Week this week is, it's Cody.
Cody! Fantastic. Thank you, Mrs. Smithson. Mr. Mole, good morning.
Good morning, Mr. Parkhouse.
I know you've been very busy in school this week. Tell us a bit about it. Who has caught your eye for Star of the Week?
Well, very busy in school this week, but I've also been trying to keep on top of all the lovely work and enthusiasm that's been pouring out of Tolkien class this week. And one person has really, really stood out to me with their such a good work rate and work ethic towards their core skills and their spellings, practicing their handwriting, alongside their work. And what I've really, really noticed about this individual is that the presentation of all of their writing and their maths is all really kind of coming into place and just really improving because of that extra work that they are putting in and that extra resilience that they are showing that's going above and beyond, really, is really transcending to the rest of their work. So that is really, really, really impressing me. Also, similar to Mrs. Smithson said, we've had some lovely posters, and this person has created a fabulous poster to put outside the house just to spread the love and positivity in their area. And also been noticing some comments that they've been leaving on other people's work on Seesaw, just to give them a little bit of a G up, and even if it's just a thumbs up to say well done. So just for spreading that positivity and taking so much resilience and improving their learning from home. Tolkien Class Star of the Week this week is Finley.
Finley! Paul, you sound incredibly proud of Finley, and rightly so. Really nice very to hear proud. That Finley's been able to pop some feedback onto other children from the class as well. What a lovely idea. Well done to you, Finley. Let's go to Miss Atkinson. Good morning.
Good morning. Well, this week, William's class have been incredible again, making it really difficult for me to choose because they've all been shining so brightly. But my star of the week has lit up our Seesaw page with his enthusiasm and passion for learning. I absolutely love the way he just gives everything a go, even when it gets a little bit tricky. And he's put a great big smile on my face with his autism awareness picture that he made outside, similar to Cody and Mrs. Smithson's class. So for making me smile every day, my star of the week, and I hope he knows how amazing he is, it's Jacob Featherston!
Thank you! Let's go to Miss Lee, good morning!
Good morning! Hello! We've had a wonderful week in our class. They have been amazing. It's been so good to see more children passionate about sharing their videos and voice recordings this week, and it's been really lovely because in the last few days we've been sharing video messages to one another as well, and I think that's really cheered up a lot of people, so that's been lovely. This person is particularly special. They've had a great time. They've had a campfire in their living room. It's been amazing. They've won their Star of the Week because they find this subject, the subject maths, really quite easy at times. However, they really persevered today and came across a challenge and really took their time and spent time thinking about it and overcame it. And so for being intrepid like Indy, and we're so proud of you, I'm giving my Star of the Week to Hector.
Mrs. Bune, hello.
Hello. You okay? Hi. I'm okay, thank you. So I've had another week, or most of the week in school, and can I just say that the children that have been in school, they've been displaying absolutely every one of our pride values. They've been passionate about learning. They've been ultra resilient because it's tough to be in school at the moment when all their friends aren't here. They've been really intrepid, really learning new things this week. All of them have been ultra dependable and they've been absolutely fantastic. And between all of them, all day, every day, all week, they have been really, really empathetic and really, really helping each other out, helping to learn new things, but also helping when people are feeling a little bit sad and things. But there is somebody who has stood out, and the other teachers and the other staff that were in school this week, we had a little chat earlier and we decided this person had really, really stood out. And I had a lovely time the other day. We put a video on and we were learning how to draw a dinosaur, and the dinosaur they drew was absolutely incredible. But all week he's been ultra, ultra dependable. So our star of the week this week for the children that have been in school is AJ.
AJ! Congratulations to you. you. Okay, I have a very long list of Head Teachers Awards here for some shout outs. It's obviously been a really successful week in school and with online learning. So here we go. Are you ready? Dan, Harry, Oscar, Lily, AJ, not once but twice, Sky, Faye, Dexter, Farah, Eve, twice, Evelyn, Beatrice, Bella, Amy, Harvey, Blanca, Bobby, Alicia, Eltian, Georgina, Emily, Jake, Ruby Rose, Lola, Florence, Kieran, Henry, Finley, Joe, Alicia, Yenka, Dylan, Isla, Lucas, Annabella, Adil, Genevieve, Florence, Jessica, George, Ella, Lily, Maisie, Charlie, Casper, Yash, Alice, Elliot, Imogen, Bobby, Daphne, Matuse, Lenny, Seth, Max, Lily, Rosie, and Izzy. Big round of applause for all of those children, please. Yay. Okay, lots of children as well, climbing to the dizzy heights of Smiley Sun. Teachers, are we ready? Sunglasses on. Ready to bask in their glorious sunshine from being so successful this week. Back to 50 on. Can we have a big round of applause for those children, please? Okay, now last week I said that normally we would have a performance from our wonderful choir led by Mr. Morland, but I didn't think that was going to be possible with our online version. But of course, ye of little faith, Mr. Mullen, being the magician that he is, has managed to work his magic and create a online choir performance for us, which we can't wait for. Is that right, Mr. Mullen?
Yeah, that's correct. Thank you to all the children who had a go at this. It wasn't the easiest thing for any of us. But I've spent a few hours knitting it all together. And I think we've got something that works and that we can be proud of. So we're going to play it in and see what everybody thinks. It's one we've heard before in school, but it's the most popular one for the choir this year, which is Hey Jude. And I'm sure you all know it anyway. So sing along with the ending.
Hey Jude, don't make it bad. Take a sad song. To let her into your heart, then you can start to make it better. Hey Jude, don't be afraid. You are made to go out and get her. The minute you let her into your skin, then you begin to make it better. And any time you feel the pain, hey Jude, refrain. Don't carry the world upon your shoulders. Well, you know that it's just a fool.
Yeah.
incredible performance. Thank you so much, Mr. Morland. What an incredible job. And a wonderful, wonderful online performance from our choir. Who'd have thought it? Amazing. Well done to all of you. So we are going to sing now again and see if we can improve our performance from last week. And say well done to everybody, all of you at home, all of our children, all of our award winners, of course. Okay, well done, everybody. Well done, Team GR. I couldn't be prouder of all of you. In fact, I think I am the proudest head teacher in the world. You have all been amazing over these last few weeks, and the whole term, of course. But these last few weeks, you have been particularly showing incredible resilience, like our friend here, and just doing such an amazing job. So well done to all of you. I hope you have a lovely Easter holiday and have some nice family time. It's time to relax, stay safe, look after each other, keep being empathetic like Ellie, being kind and looking after everyone in your home. But for now, from me and all of the teachers, happy Easter, and we'll see you all again very, very soon. Yeah.